In this screencast, we're going to use the atomic species balances method to solve for a reaction. So we have 100 moles of ethane, and they are sent to a reactor, and they react to form ethylene and hydrogen gas. So let's write out that reaction. So we have ethane, and that goes to ethylene plus hydrogen gas. However, some of the ethylene, our C2H4, reacts with ethane and it forms propylene and methane. And given the information that the fractional conversion of ethane is 0.7, and the selectivity of ethylene to propylene is 5, we want to find the composition of the product gas. Coming in, as we said, we have 100 moles of ethane. And coming out in the product gas, we have our ethane, since that wasn't completely converted. We have our ethylene, which is our desired product. We have hydrogen gas. We have propylene. And finally, we have methane. So let's do a degree of freedom analysis on this and make sure that this can actually be solved. So how many unknowns do we have? Well, we have the 5 unknowns that are coming out in the product gas, and we have 2 atomic species. That's the carbon and the hydrogen. We have the selectivity as well as the conversion. And finally, if we look at this second equation, we have the fact that methane and propylene come out in the same molar ratio. So given that information, we see that our degrees of freedom are 0. So that means that this can be solved. So let's look at some of the equations that we're going to use to solve this. So the first one we look at is the fractional conversion. So 0.7 equals the moles fed in of ethane minus the moles of ethane that come out of the reactor divided by the moles of ethane. And what that allows us to do is solve for the moles of ethane, which is 30 moles. The next thing that we know is that the selectivity of our ethylene to propylene is 5. And finally, we know that our number of moles of propylene have to equal the number of moles of ethane. Now let's do our atomic species balances. And in atomic species balances, we balance the number of atoms on each side. So the first thing that we're going to do is balance the carbon atoms first, which come in. So we have 100 moles of our ethane, and there are 2 carbons for every 1 mole of ethane. And that's all the carbon that comes in. Let's see what comes out. Well, we know that there are 30 moles of ethane that come out. And again, there are 2 carbons per mole of ethane. And then we add to that the number of moles of our ethylene. And we see again, 2 carbons for every mole of ethylene. In addition, we have our propylene. So in every mole of propylene, we have 3 carbons per mole. We also have our methane, and in our methane, we have one carbon for every mole of methane. So this is what's known as a carbon balance. The next atomic species that we'll do is the hydrogen balance. And we do it exactly the same way. So we have our five unknowns, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 equations. Five equations, five unknowns, we can solve this problem. Now, since we were asked for the composition, we're going to need to find the total number of moles, and that equals 160 moles. Our composition, which is our mole fraction, is going to be the number of moles of one of our substances divided by the total number of moles. For example, if we want to look at the mole fraction of the ethane in the product gas, that would be 30 divided by 160, which equals 0.18. So here's our composition for the product stream coming out of the reactor, and hopefully this will help you in trying to use the atomic species balances method when you're dealing with two reactions.